Hello students, good morning and welcome to the session of EVS 2. Do you see this picture? Yes, what do you see in the picture? Different styles of houses, right? So what are we going to study today in this chapter? We are going to study our home and environment. Means what is the connection of our home with the environment. Why our houses are built of different types. When we go to different areas, we see different types of houses are built. Why they are of different style? What is the need of that? Why there is a need to build different styles of houses? And even we have seen different types of materials. As you can see in the picture, very clearly that all the houses are of different styles. Their construction style is different. Plus, some houses have same materials used and some houses have different materials. So let us see what this picture says with the help of the question given in your textbook. So on the way to your school or market or when you travel to another town, you see many things, correct? We see bazaars, we see markets, we see lot of things, malls and shopping centers and also different types of houses. Observe carefully the houses which you see. When you are walking, when you are moving from your house to somewhere else, you should observe the houses. Note the construction. You have to see what type of construction is there. Note the shape, what type of shape of the houses are there. Building material and other aspects of the different houses. Now how you can do that? For example, now you are staying in Mumbai. When you are going here and there, you will see lot of buildings and bungalows and houses, chawls like. And when you go to your native place during vacations, over there you can observe what type of houses you see. So this way you can do your assignment. Do some of the houses resemble the specimens shown above? Do you see the houses similar to the one shown in picture? Might be possible. There are many houses like that. So let's see the questions. What materials are used for building houses? First thing you have to see, what are the materials used for building houses? Then what is the second one? Compare any two types of houses that you saw and note down the difference. The two houses which you have seen, you have to see the differences. What differences are there in both the houses? Then the third is, what are the different things from which a house gives us protection? Now you have to think that what different things is there which our house protect us. Then, in what way are the houses A, B and C different? Do you see the picture of A, B and C? Are they similar? Do the things or materials used in that is similar? No, all the three are different. First one, A is hut. It's built with straws and wood and wattle and daub. Mostly this type of houses we see in a very remote villages, small villages. Then B is made up of leaves and bamboos. This type of houses now here to be seen, now it is not to be seen because earlier the ancient peoples used to build such type of houses made up of leaves and bamboos, correct? And then C, you will see this kind of house in most of the places, in cities also, in villages also. So, fifth one is, which of the above houses are mainly seen in cities? So, what houses mostly we see in cities? C, D, F, correct? Mostly we see such type of houses in cities. Which are seen mainly in the rural areas, which you see mostly in the villages only. So what type of houses you see in villages mostly? Like A and E type of houses, correct? Now, think about your own environment and the climate there and choose the most suitable house for yourself by putting a tick in the box near the picture. Now what you have to do is see your environment, what type of environment is there where you are living, and according to the environment and climate which you have in your area, you have to choose one house for you and you have to put a mark on it. Okay, so now our third question was, what are the different things from which a house gives us protection? So what are the answer for that? The answer is, we saw different types of houses in the pictures. Their main uses can be listed below. So these are the uses, means these are the things from which house gives us protection, and also it gives uses. First use of the house is, it gives us shelter, right? We can go and stay at our home, we can relax at our home. Our home is served us as a resting place. Wherever we are going for a trip, for a picnic, or anywhere when we go, where we come and rest, where we feel relaxed after coming back, at home only, correct? So it is a resting place. Then third, it gives us protection against the sun, wind, cold and rains. It protects us from all these things. Then it protects us from wild animals. And the last, it keeping ourselves safe from antisocial elements. Our houses are keeping safe from antisocial elements. Now what are these antisocial elements? Antisocial elements means bad peoples which are there in the society, means robbers, thieves, correct? So our house protects us from all these antisocial elements. Now here you can see the map of India and different types of houses, picture of the houses given over here. This is shown that according to the different types of environment, different styles of houses are built in our country. Here in mountainous areas, this type of houses are there. Then in desert area, this type of houses are there. In marshy areas, these are there. Region of low rainfall, these type of houses are there. Heavy rainfall, these type of houses are there, where you always have a slopy roof. Then in medium rainfall, these type of houses are there, made up of straw, correct, and made up of wattle and daub. So based on the different types of environment, different styles of houses are built. So the above figure shows a map of India and the types of houses that are common in the respective regions. Since ancient times, how the construction or structure of the house changes from region to region. So when you visit from area to area, from one place to another place, from region to region, you will see the different styles of houses based on the area in which the area is, in which region, you will see different styles of houses. So how many examples are given over here? 7. Regions of heavy rainfall, regions of medium rainfall, low rainfall, desert region, marshy, mountainous and plain region, and based on this given the types of houses. Now with the help of the map which we have seen, you can answer this question as, like, when you see plain region, you will see the type flat roofed house. Mostly you will see the flat roofed house. Shape will be rectangular. The materials used for building houses, wood and earth, and walls are made up of stone and earth. Same way, after observing other regions with the help of map and the type of houses shown in the picture, you can answer the region. Any 4 you have to do. 1 is done, 4 you have to do with the help of the map. Now, people build houses to suit the climate of their region. Why we build houses, and what do we see before building houses? We see our environment, in which environment we are living. Whether our house is going to protect us with that environment, by thinking all these things, then we build our house. For building our house, we use natural resources, whatever is available. differences in the construction and building materials give rise to the different types of houses. So as we use different types of materials, different types of construction method we are using, that's why we see different types of houses. Now, water, food, clothing and shelter are what? They are our basic needs. These are the basic needs of every human being. However, these needs are not fulfilled in the case of each and every person. Do each and every person on this earth have house? No, there are many families who don't have house. Then the following situation arises. Then what happened when the people don't have house? The situation is, around us, we see many people who lack shelter. So many people, so many examples you can see. Mostly we'll see this in the cities, where you see the people seeking shelter. They are taking shelter under the bridges, tumble down buildings, on railway and bus station, even on open grounds. As you can see in this picture. What do you see in this picture? The family is there. And where are they living? Are they living in the house? No. They are living on a footpath. They build a temporary tent with the plastic or something. And there only they are living. Why they are living like that? Do they have a house and then also they are living? No. They are forced to live this kind of life because they don't have home. They are homeless. So, many people are forced to be homeless because there are many reasons behind it. Why they are homeless? Because they have insufficient or no means of livelihood. Nobody likes to stay like this. Do anyone like to live in a footpath? No. But still, if they are living, so there are reasons behind it. What are the reasons? That means they don't have money. If they would have money, they can buy the home, right? But buying home is not an easy thing. Now the prices of houses are going so much high, correct? So because of this, no means of livelihood means they don't have work. If they don't have work, they are not getting money. And if they don't have money, they cannot do anything good for themselves. So they are forced to live like this. A section of our society being homeless is a social problem. Homelessness is not a personal problem. It is a social problem. That is why the government starts up with many schemes and trying to provide homes to the homeless people. In some of the cities, the government makes night shelters also, where these people who are forced to live in on a footpath, many times we see on the dividers also, people sleep, correct? Both the sides, vehicles are going with a very fast speed and on the divider, people are sleeping. It's very dangerous, very, very dangerous for their life. So that's why night shelters are available to such peoples where they can go and sleep. Now, why people become homeless? The chart is given over here. You can see the chart. There are six reasons given over here. First is lack of affordable housing because they cannot afford to buy house. Second, inadequate income. They don't have income. Whatever they are earning, it goes in their food and other things only. They cannot save because very less they are earning and that is gone spent in their daily things only, daily needs only. That's why they cannot save money to buy the house. Poverty. Poverty means no money, no food, nothing. They are very poor. Poverty means poor. Then comes unemployment. No job. The people, those who don't have any work, from where they are going to get money? That's why they are forced to live such kind of life. Then another reason is natural disaster. Sometimes what happened because of some natural disaster, flood, earthquake, houses are damaged. There are loss of properties and life also sometimes. So lot of houses are getting damaged and because of this, people are forced to live in such type of conditions. Then another last reason is physical and mental disorder. Now, what is this reason? Many times we see people on railway or bus stop, they are talking to themselves, they are little mad like people, correct? They have some mental problems. And many times what happens, they run away from home and start staying here and there. So such kind of people also we see living on our footpath, under the bridges, in a park, on railway station, on bus stop, all these areas we see such peoples. So here we all have a right to clean, potable water, sufficient food, safe shelter and education. These are our basic needs. Each and every person on this earth have the right to have clean water, to drink clean water, to have sufficient food, to have safe shelter. Everybody should have house and also to be get educated. These are our basic needs, but unfortunately there are many peoples who are not able to get these basic needs also. With this, we have finished with the one part of this chapter. In my next video, I'll continue with the next part. Till then, take care.